Community TV honors and acknowledges that we create video content on Treaty 7, Treaty 4 territories, traditional lands of the Siksika, Kainai, Piikani, Stony Nakota, Tsuut'ina, Cree, Sioux, and Saltino bands of the Ojibwe peoples. We also acknowledge that we are on Métis Nation Region 3. This content is created with the help of fans and local businesses that sponsor the content. Sponsors don't necessarily endorse all of the content, they support your access to relevant news and stories. What can you tell me?
Well, all I know is about masks and vaccines and all mandates, no different than the trucker convoy.
Gotcha.
But are you fake news like the rest of them, or are you going to be honest with me?
Well, I mean, I want to tell the truth of what happened. Go ahead.
Well, if I say something, I don't want you to mix my words and try to...
No, generally what I do is if I interview somebody, if I talk to them on the phone, I include that whole entire conversation. I don't try and snip it up to make it something that it's not, you know. I just But so my big question would be about, like, do you know how many students, like, I don't know Eagle Butte all that well. How many students go to that school?
How many students go to Eagle Butte? Let's see. I couldn't give you an answer to that one.
Like about 100 or...
There's way more than 100.
Yeah, because I moved here from Halifax years ago, and I know where the school is, but I honestly couldn't picture it in my head, like, how big it is or how many kids go there. So yeah. I would kind of be thinking along the lines of, like, did...
I'm gonna say probably 300 kids.
Okay, yeah, I mean, that's about the size of the high school I went to. Did all the kids walk out? Did half the kids walk out? Did 100 kids walk out?
I'm gonna say more than half of the kids walked out.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
And so, like, how did it all get planned out?
Well, it's just, I mean, you see it all on the internet and stuff like that, where they want to do a protest all across the Alberta, and you mean it's a, and everybody, you mean, the kids jumped on it and they went with it. You mean it? These kids, like, how long do you want to punish kids for? Right? These kids are getting punished every day. All days, they gotta have masks, they gotta do this, they gotta get vaccines, they can't go to this place, they can't go to that place. Like, you mean this is mental abuse?
I'm not a parent that has a kid in school, but, like, so you have to, your kid has to get a vaccine to go to Eagle Butte now?
No, but they do, like, you mean for hockey and stuff like that, we gotta go get the negative test every time we wanna do something, we gotta pay for a negative test, right?
Yeah.
$40, like... You know what I mean? Like, when does this end?
Quick shout out to the sponsors like 24/7 Rideshare. Download the app. You can get a ride. It's just like Uber in Medicine Hat. Our local Gas King. Earn and save 6 cents per liter with your King card. The fabulous and wonderful Cliff Restaurant in the beautiful Clarion Point Hotel.
Yeah, I think everybody wants this thing to end. Yeah. It doesn't matter what side of the thing you fall on, whether you're sitting in the class with a mask on or you're the one who says, rah, 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 let's screw the mask. Yeah. Everybody wants it to end.
Unless you're a Nazi and you're okay with that stuff.
Yeah, I don't know. Do you think there's Nazis out at Eagle Butte?
Well, no, but what I'm saying is our government is full of them.
Yeah, I mean, some people have been making that argument. And I think, for me, it's a little bit of a stretch because I actually do know some Jewish families that have people who survived persecution in that time. And I think... Maybe if the Liberal Party or the government that we currently have are Nazis, they're really slow at doing the Nazi thing because the Holocaust was a little quicker. You know what I'm saying? Like,
you got guys in that. You can't tell me that those people are not in the Liberal Party. And you know what? There's conservatives too, but it comes down to money. All these people got money. School boards got money. All these people, they got paid. Trudeau got paid. You got the guy in Manitoba. He got paid to put out this fake lies.
To like, when you say fake lies, you mean, like, to promote the...
The health thing that the government
says was good. Yeah.
If this is such a deadly disease, then why do we have masks and stuff like that? Wouldn't we have boxes to drop in, like, needles and stuff like that?
You
know when you take a needle?
Yeah.
You put it in the box. It's like a safety box.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. So if it's such a deadly disease, these masks don't work. It's been proven. I mean, I work in the oil field, and I know that those masks are absolutely useless.
Hmm. Well, what they're saying, and this is just like, I am no scientist, but I do understand, try and, you know, break things down in layman's terms, that the virus, if it's being transmitted around, it's because it's in the droplet of somebody's aerosol that would come out of their mouth or their breath if they were to cough or sneeze. Yeah. So the size of the virus might be really, really, really small, and it would go right in through a mask. Yeah. But
hold on.
You didn't even let me finish, man. I'm trying to drop some knowledge. Just give me 1 second on this. Just give me 1 second, right? And so everybody says, well, if you look at the size of the virus and then you look at the size of the mask, it's like, you know, pitching darts at a fence, the chain link fence, and the darts are going to go through, right? But what they fail to talk about is that we're talking about droplets that contain those molecules, and the size of the droplet is about the size of a soccer ball, and if you kick a soccer ball at a chain link fence, it doesn't go through. So scientifically, yeah, masks do work, and the CDC has proved that, and you know what I mean? Like, that is a thing, that if I cough into a mask in your face, it's going to be better than if I have no mask at all. I mean, that's just science. I mean... I'm not saying that I think every single kid in school should be wearing one right now, but I am saying that I kind of agree with the science that says that wearing a mask prevents respiratory illnesses. My dad had a double lung transplant long before all this COVID stuff. So, I mean, our household was a household where if you came in wearing perfume, my dad had to retreat because he couldn't breathe in that shit, you know? So, yeah, I mean, like, masks are somewhat useful, but I agree with the people that are saying this has been too long. We're into the Omicron thing now. I mean, it's either everybody's getting it or you know, they're going to deal with it. They're not going to die from it. So this, you know, it's like, it's almost like we're coming to the end of it anyway. You know, like, I feel like the restrictions are probably going to be lifted this summer just via science anyway. But well, I understand why people are mad and want it now, you know.
Jason Kenney said he's supposed to drop it next week and Saskatchewan dropped it altogether.
Yeah.
You got other countries that are going obsolete with this stuff.
Yeah.
One country didn't even do it.
Yeah.
I buy my pet food from Rob at Animal World. Medicine Hat Pizza has 4.8 out of 5 stars on Facebook, and I highly recommend the Donair. 616 has virtual reality and axe throwing and a whole bunch of other cool stuff. 616 Entertainment in downtown Medicine Hat.
Well, I mean, yeah, and like I said, I think that if, even if we're behind looking at the science and going, okay, well, let's even give it an extra 2 weeks or an extra 2 months because we're not sure. Every time the science says one thing, we find out it's something different after. The Canadian government's just being, like, extremely cautious so that they don't end up putting people at risk. And the level of caution that they're taking feels to some people like too much caution. Like, some people wear a helmet when they ride a bike. Some people don't. But they don't want to be told you have to wear a helmet every time you ride a bike. You know, it's like... That's the way I see it.
You mean back to the school, it's...
Yeah.
These kids have had enough, and it's time to let everybody move on.
Yeah.
Get on with their lives. You know what? The strong will survive, and if you mean it's... Who's dying? I don't know anybody that's died outside of the thing, right?
Yeah, I mean, the kids at Eagle Butte High School aren't dying. I mean, we're not seeing it happen, like, on a local scale. But I guess then the next question is, so who's... Is it the principal that made those rules, or is it the provincial?
Here, let's do this. Let's back up here.
Sure.
I'm gonna end this, and I don't even want you to post this at all. Actually.
Oh.
I don't feel comfortable in doing this. So.
Hey, that's fine.
I don't want you to post this. Okay. Thanks.
All right. Well, thanks for talking to me. Okay. Well, I mean, you know, you sort of want to ask some questions and find some things out, and somebody says they want to give you a tip on the news, and I mean, I want to ask reasonable questions and find out things like how many of the kids walked out, and you know, why is it that they walked out, and who is their complaint to, and what are their demands, and you know, there doesn't seem to be any answers there from that individual who now says that they don't want to give a news tip. Pandemic, convoy, headache, journalism.
Gold Dust Jewelry closed the retail location and now operates online by phone and personal meetings. Gold Dust Jewelry restores and repairs, resizes and customizes. Goldust Jewelry can 3D print anything you can imagine.
Everybody, come on in. Let's check out a little sneak peek on the new shop. Things are happening. We're down to the very last stage for me. License approved. Yay!
Truckers, 24/7 restaurant next to the gas station on the right-hand side of the number one highway as you come into Medicine Hat from Red Cliff. Truckers is a home-cooked meal and a very popular stop for cross-country truckers. Check Skip the Dishes for Truckers tonight. Do you need a lawyer? Call 403-527-3030, the law office of Yarshenko and Heidinger. If you've been charged with a criminal or regulatory offense, the law office of Yarshenko and Heidinger has experience, skill, and the demonstrated track record to professionally and ably guide you through the legal process. If you've been charged with a criminal offense, the law office of Yarshenko and Heidinger wants to represent you. Call for a consultation, 403-527-3030. That's 403-527-3030. Call my lawyer, 403-527-3030. Community TV is only possible with fan subscriptions from fans like you and sponsorships from local businesses. Sponsoring this community TV content is a great way to show community engagement and an inexpensive way to advertise your brand. Thank you very much for watching Community TV. Right now, until the end of the year, I'm having a big push for fan subscriptions on the Facebook page. If we reach 500 fan subscribers, I will make a $1,000 donation to the charity of your choosing. We have 15,000 followers now, so that's only 3.4%. Just buy me coffee once a month, and we can improve the quality and delivery of local stories. As a fan subscriber to Community TV, you'll also receive exclusive content, access to live videos, and entries into the 15,000 fan giveaway, which is going to include lots of great local prizes.